and a win that will stand this time around.
Singapore, home to Formula One's greatest night race. Blisteringly quick straights, sharp hairpin turns, and dangerous bumps. The Singapore Grand Prix hosted some of the most legendary races with breath-stopping drama and euphoria. And after a two-year break, this race is finally back with a bang.
This right here is the float at the Marina Bay. It's also known as Turn 17 of the Singapore Grand Prix. It has also been the host for National Day celebrations every single year for decades. So it is an honour for the Singapore Grand Prix to be hosted on this soil. It is common knowledge that the first ever Grand Prix was held here at the Marina Bay Circuit in 2008. Well, I'm here to tell you that that's wrong, because the first ever Grand Prix was actually held in 1961 at a completely different racetrack. The first ever Singapore Grand Prix was held here. For over 12 years, 13 Grand Prix were held over this very tarmac. This is the Thompson Grand Prix. In the 1960s, motorsport was booming. Civilian cars were becoming more and more powerful. And because the entire world was on a chase for speed, racing became more popular.
All roads led to Upper Thompson Road for the three-day 1966 Grand Prix meeting, which was held over Easter weekend. Coupers, Cortinas, Mazdas, Princes, and hot favourite for the last event of the meeting, the Grand Prix for motor cars, Lee Hensing found himself at the head of the field and ran out an easy and highly popular winner of the 1966 Grand Prix for cars.
From 1961 to 65, the Malaysian Grand Prix was held here. And after her exit from Malaysia, the Singapore Grand Prix was born. Lee Hensing was the first local driver to win here in his Lotus 22. The following year, Rodney Siah won in his Merlin Mark 10. Noting its innate thirst for speed, the Singapore Grand Prix was officially announced as a partner of the International Motorsport Calendar.
Over the years, the Grand Prix gained immense popularity. In 72, colour TV came out, and the race was screened across Asia and sold as half-hour films in Europe. In 73, there was live commentary with telecast.
Spectators could walk around the track and watch the race from any angle they wanted, and this was unheard of, even today. People loved the track so much, it was used for everything: F1 cars, sports cars, humble civilian cars, bikes, and sometimes even bicycles.
This beautiful track consisted of a long straight, followed by a multitude of high-speed bends called the snakes, before reaching one of the tighter corners. The cars would move down long loop and then to range hairpin, to then pick up speed again on the straight. 4.8 kilometers of asphalt spaghetti draped beside a river. What could possibly go wrong? Quite a lot, actually.
Where I'm standing at right now is the longest straight off the track, called Thompson Mile. But towards 1972, as the race got a bit more controversial, this line was renamed or dubbed to Murder Mile. And this corner is not where you would want to confess your sins, because after taking many lives, it's now called Devil's Bend. And it has been taking lives since 1960 to as recently as 2008. Singapore's racing ace Lionel Chan, dubbed Speed King, was among them. He passed away after suffering severe injuries to his body and head in a crash. 7 lives were lost in total: 4 drivers, 2 riders, and 1 marshal. In comparison, the Macau and Monaco Grand Prix had 3 and 4 deaths, respectively. In 1973, the Singapore Sports Council discontinued the race on safety concerns, because the rate at which the cars were increasing in speed and acceleration was so great that the safety measures couldn't keep up. The safety infrastructure at that time was laughable. It included just a few dirt bags, some hay, and some trees, which obviously raised concerns. Worst of all of the corners rested beside a ravine.
Okay, I just fell from my bicycle because my tripod fell off, and as I was recollecting myself, I saw this. This is at least a 30-foot drop into God knows where. Now, I am questioning the decisions of the Singapore Sports Council as to how they thought having a corner right beside a ravine was a good idea. And it's not even on one side. Let me show you the other side. I was right here, yeah? And across the road is this. At least a 50 to 60 feet drop. God bless, there are tires there.
In 1974, there was an attempt to revive the race, but the authorities arrived to a conclusion that the track was going to be dangerous no matter what. Singapore had been making plans for a new permanent Grand Prix, so an ad hoc team was set up in 1972 to build the best racetrack in Singapore. But even until April 73, the project was still in the planning stage. The slow progress was the nail in the coffin for the Thompson Grand Prix. 30 years later, this city got its taste for speed again. With the rise in tourism and a demand for a night race in the city, Singapore grabbed the opportunity and the Grand Prix was reborn. From a circuit that lacked basic infrastructure to becoming one of the best in the world, its comeback is poetic. A ticket to the Grand Prix back then was about $10, equivalent to about $80 today. But the Grand Prix tickets today cost at least $400. And for a broke boy like me, I can't afford it. Maybe not this year, but perhaps in the future, I will have the opportunity to see the world's greatest cars zoom past me.
This doesn't feel real. Friday night, FP2. Sean comes up with me, with his uncle, and tells me that he has one free ticket. Here I am on Friday night, 1 hour before. Crazy.